The protectors of the pass fought their way into the guard tower, overrun by Regessian soldiers and an inquisitor. The battle was a game of inches, and many of the protectors went down. Wow. And many of the protectors went down to the brutal... That doesn't make any sense. Let me back up. The battle was a game of inches, and many of the protectors fell unconscious during the melee. But digging deep, the protectors fought back their enemy and won the day, defeating the soldiers, the Inquisitor, and capturing one of their number. Their mission was a success. That's it.
Short and sweet.
Yep.
We left things off at just being able to stabilize everybody, including one of the orcs, which was kind of one of your main points here that you were trying to get. And yeah, everybody just starting to come to consciousness, get together, and figure things out from here.
I assume that we tie up the boy that we kept alive.
Who wants to lead that?
Absolutely. I can limp over and up on that.
Sure, you can go ahead and do it with advantage. You got plenty of hands to help here. But go ahead.
Stephanie is saying guidance over and over again. Perfect.
You can also have guidance apparently. Okay. Go ahead and make a sleight of hand check.
Ooh, with guidance, which is a d4, right?
It is.
Shouldn't need it, but I rolled a 4 on my d4, and I rolled an 18 with the advantage. So, plus my, you said sleight of hand, which is another plus 4, so 8, which is 26.
Nice. Solid numbers.
Pretty good.
You secure him tightly with some rope to tie him up to the best of your abilities. He's pretty groggy out of it at this point in time, so it's not... There's not a lot of fighting going on at this moment from him.
I'm going to stand up, and while they're accomplishing that, I'm going to walk limp over the door and start to look for my brothers in arms.
You're going to the door at the back, further in?
Yeah, and then...
But you kind of can go through the rubble initially, and then there's a couple of doors back
limp,
there.
Kind of crawl my way over all of these broken stones and wooden beams. Yeah. The dust is still settling.
Sure, where you want to go?
I'm going to try and listen for voices if there's anyone alive. Otherwise, I'm going to try and maybe go to this hatch here.
Okay. So you listen first. Go ahead and make a perception check in the quiet of the stillness after the battle.
I could use roll 20 for this. Trying some new stuff here with my mouse. 19 perception?
Yep.
Ooh.
Let's see. I don't remember off the top of my head.
Hi.
Perception's wisdom, Ryan.
I don't have my stat lock pulled up.
Oh.
I'm ill.
Plus one.
Plus one, apparently, so 20. Okay. You don't hear anything. It is still. It is silent. As far as you can tell, there's no rats even. Like, you've decimated the place at this point. The only living beings.
I'm gonna cast Aura Vitality, and when I get back, I'm gonna roll everybody some hit points. Because I can do it as a bonus action. So I'm gonna go finish my job, and then I'll do that while Ryan does his thing.
Yeah.
Okay.
I'll open up this thing here. Because I imagine I'm crawling through the rubble, and I see the hatch there first. I know there's doors.
You gotta shove things off the hatch first, kind of wrench it open. It's heavy because of all the junk on it, but it's well oiled, well greased, this sort of thing. Opens nice and smoothly for you. Down below is just mundane supplies, basically. It's like a larder mostly. There's also a bunch of like boxes full of assorted goods, wood for the winter, for fires, you know, things like this. Very straightforward, mundane supplies. No people, no bodies, no anything like that that you'd be potentially looking for.
I'll breathe a sigh of relief. Is the orc awake?
You can have him be awake whenever you want him to be.
All right, then I'll wait. I'll imagine he's like still unconscious. Anybody else want to go?
I would ask. Clara, Bryn, can you guys help me lift this? It's not really my specialty, you know, lift with the legs, but my legs aren't that strong. So, excuse me. I want to get the try to get the rubble off of the Inquisitor to try to get her stuff, specifically her mask.
Okay. It takes you a little bit of time, but you're able to get the stuff off of her as much as you can. And get down to the Inquisitor once more and finding her stuff. What you find at the bottom is a couple of broken items, unfortunately. The mask is cracked in half. There is the white and the black sides of this mask, the half obsidian, half ivory looking. It's basically just snapped in half.
Oh, is it still held together, though?
It is not held together, but you could take the two halves if you wanted to. Okay. It's not like crushed into bits. It's like snapped in half.
I was hoping to be hanging on by like a hinge or something, but I will take it.
The other thing that you find is the remnants of a shattered vial. And there is a deep red stain mixing with her blood.
Does she still have everything else? The claws, the bear skin, all the rest of that?
Yep, you have the hand claw, if you'd like. And then, there's like a... skin, yeah, he said it. A skin cloak, kind of.
And then, out of curiosity, does she have anything on her that would tell me what her name was?
Nothing that you can find.
Like maybe on the inside of the claw, it says like property of.
Property of.
Journal. Lost, return to.
Yeah, nothing like that, unfortunately.
Follow me on Instagram.
Our unconscious friend over there might know her name.
That's true.
That's a good point.
I'm just sitting with
Why do you need this broken mask?
Well, when I was in court, I was able to throw a broken mask, or I was able to throw an Inquisitor mask to another Inquisitor to try to intimidate, or at least to increase their aggression. And it was maybe a bit foolish, but it seemed like the right thing to do in the moment. And now I'm all out of masks. So I'd like to have
one
more.
It may have made them a little more wary as to strength, but perhaps not.
It might not have had as much strategic benefit as I had originally hoped, but it was still fun and cool, I think.
You want to give it another go? Cool.
Yeah, and now that it's snapped in half, I could actually do it to two more people because I just have these two halves.
I keep forgetting that she's not Winry. I was like, and man, Winry is sassy. And I was like, oh, wait, it's not her.
At least the sass was noticeable. Doing a good job. You're doing a
right?
good job, Cassie.
Yeah.
Do all of us think that we could ride still tonight, or should we rest before heading back?
I think we should probably rest, Jack. I don't know if you saw, but I was down. Sir Sterling was down.
Yes, but I believe that we have enough magic that we could get all of you on your feet.
I'm working on that right now.
While you're doing that, I'll give you a second level healing word.
Wait, I can do me?
Yeah. You're talking about being hurt? Wait, I don't know why I'm rolling a d&dbeyond. I don't want to do that.
Why don't you let Bryn do her Aura of Vitality first, just to make sure?
Here, I'm going to do it this way. You guys can keep going. I was going to roll all 10.
Well,
and then we can divide them up.
I guess I see an office in the map, but I have no reason to know it's there. So I would say maybe now that the melee has concluded, this one that we captured could answer some questions for us. And I assume Sterling is back at this time.
No, I'm yelling, Dello, Captain Stormstrike. I'm like yelling just into the abyss of this place.
As Sterling kind of yells around, kind of searching through the various rooms, pulls open the door to the back, to the barracks that she knows back there, kind of lined with beds, this sort of thing. Just kind of yell inwards, no responses. Go into what would be like the captain's quarters, like what Jack was mentioning over there. Yell into there. Nothing. It's full silence, ominous, empty.
So I forget who was down. Sterling was down, I was down, and Clara.
I was down.
No, you were down.
Okay.
I don't think Clara went down.
No.
I'm not.
I never went down.
What was that, Cassie?
I'm not terrible.
Yeah, I'm okay too.
Okay, so.
Gosh, what a tank.
As Sterling, as you're searching through the barracks back there, kind of looking under the beds, things like this, trying to find bodies or anything that looks like it might have come from a conflict, something like this, you are able to find a pack, a like satchel, basically. And you can take that with you if you'd like to.
Sure, I'll pick it up if it doesn't look like it should be there, like it belongs. I'll walk back then. Is the orc awake yet?
If you want him to be, whenever you want.
All right, I'll let them decide.
Before that, I just want to say real quick that while Clara and Myetharia or Bryn are helping me, Myetharia can help too if she wants. I think we should try to take things off of the soldiers that would indicate they're Regessian, just in case we need a little bit more ammo for Dash Commander Timor. So, like, I don't know, arm patches, if they're wearing any kind of, like, emblem, things like this. Can I find something like that, Justin?
You could probably find something similar to that, yeah.
Okay.
I was trying to make sure that they would be wearing.
Yeah, that's kind of why I was asking, because they might not, because they're trying to maintain some kind of illusion.
Subtlety.
We have the. I mean, we have subterfuge. We have the Inquisitor stuff. What's in the bag? Actually, I don't really care. I'm gonna throw the bag at Jack and say, here, check
I'm gonna
out.
Give Sterling, you take 26, Myetharia, you take 24, and I'm taking 20.
I rolled a 16 dexterity check to catch it.
Oh, so you catch it. I'm gonna toss, you know, I'm not like doing like a Rayland thing, I'm tossing it like, hey, check this out.
Can I catch it like I'm expecting Raylan to throw something?
Yeah, you're so kind like, ah!
It's like a big satchel bag, basically, that he tosses at you, and it thumps into you kind of heavily. As you pull it open, it's papers inside. It's not like potions or anything like this that you might have thought might be breakable. It's papers. And the top one that you pull out amounts to orders, a series of orders. Says, take the first outpost, stay put, supply drops every other day.
Oh no.
When we learn the success or failure of madness, our weather mages will break the winter over the gap. When the thaw begins, prepare to take more outposts.
What?
The success or failure of madness of King Stepengard.
But what was the last part about weather mages?
I should note, the madness is capitalized.
Oh,
something
specific.
It's referring to King Steppengard.
There is a person. There's a person called Madness, I'm sure.
Yeah, that's his code name.
Which, by the way,
it's
what was the name?
It's not thawing outside, right?
Not currently. Nope.
Why can
they all control the weather? This sucks.
Go ahead, Ryan.
What
did you say?
Characters in the Fire Force. So there was Indomitability, and then what was the other character?
Deception. Mm-hmm. Madness might be another one.
We have Madness. Ladies and gentlemen, we have Madness. So,
we have another child, Trillet,
that we're dealing with here. And I am guessing it is Nina. 100% Nina is a Trillet in disguise. But, let's just say...
Like you said, I'm guessing 100%. I'm guessing that I'm totally certain.
Sorry. You know what? You're
absolutely right.
I am like 100% in my mind on that Nina is this child of Trillith. And that's not a guess. So,
Justin, can you is it easy to link the letter?
Yes, I will in a second.
Okay. Thank you.
Oh boy. But every other day, supply drops every other day, so they're gonna know that we've taken the post back. That's what my exclamation of worry was mid-sentence of Justin's was, oh no.
Yeah. Well, I think we get the evidence and skedaddle. It's not gonna matter. Yeah. They're gonna come after us.
We don't wanna be here when they're here.
They're just gonna know that we know, that's all.
Yeah, which... That's good for us because we'll hopefully have united Dasin at that point. There's going to be a confrontation with Regesia, but the question is, are we going to have that confrontation with Regesia as like a strong Dasin nation or as like this nation in civil war, which is obviously like that's their goal to have the civil war that they can just waltz through. Yeah. Anyway,
civil war make us weaker.
What do we think about the weather mage part?
Yeah,
making the winter happen?
They made the hurricane happen. Why else would they make something else happen?
Why would they do
that?
No,
they're trying to melt it. They're trying to melt it so that because that's what's been holding them back all these years is
well they're holding themselves
that's what's been
back.
Holding them back right now. That's what's
it's
been
a little,
holding themselves back right now.
But they're holding themselves back. Like that's what's weird about it, right? They're we can't attack you because this weather. Oh, this weather's so crazy, and they're the ones doing it. Like that's very like. Just don't like. Just if you don't want to attack Dasin, like just don't attack Dasin. I don't quite understand
They'll break the winter. No, it doesn't say that they're keeping up the winter. It says that they'll break the winter because that's what's holding them back and making
it
slower.
Justin said their mages. Their mages are doing the winter spell, right?
So I literally read our weather mage associates will break the winter over the Illidi Gap.
So it might not be that.
Oh, you're right.
But if they have the capability, then why are they waiting?
So the other thing is, though,
they're waiting for they're waiting for civil war. That makes sense. Okay.
Yeah.
Wait, sorry.
The other thing, though, is that the winter, we have to remember, is still unnatural at this point.
Right.
Mm-hmm.
So even if they're not doing it, something's not right.
Somebody is doing the winter to stop the Regesians. I imagine the Regesians were held up a certain amount of time to try and figure it out, and they have now figured out how to drop the winter. They just haven't yet. So
it could be what Steph just said, where it's like they need to wait for the civil war to start so that they won't.
They're waiting for it too. But like maybe they would have come in sooner. Actually, I don't know. Maybe it still doesn't quite make sense. But either way,
if they have the capability, they could have just done it. But they probably are just waiting for civil war to break out and have everything fall, from within before they attack from without.
If it was somebody else who was trying to stall the army, they're probably sitting somewhere thinking, look it, I've done it, I've stalled the army. And they're like, they don't know that Regesia is just like kind of like snickering at them for being like, look at these,
Yeah.
So
there's some idiot somewhere who thinks they've done a good job. That's what I'm trying to say. happening.
So if we're suspecting Madness to be another one of the Trillith, and that would imply that they are in league with Regesia to further the war, then why was indomitability and deception in the Fire Forest? Because Stabengard said to us that putting those fires out increased, opened that route up for people to come through. So why was indomitability and deception keeping that whole thing, Ineditar on fire? Why were they keeping Ineditar on fire would have furthered Regizia's cause?
It was my understanding that Indomitability did not want to be on fire, and that
True. I mean, he was being
trapped.
Indomitability had been there for
That's
40 years.
Yeah. Now,
and they
could
be such like big entities that they maybe have gotten one, but
I also don't think
they're still big entities doing their own thing.
Yeah. It would make sense then why deception was there, because then perhaps he was trying to find a way to, because he was trying to like have them all just give up.
I also
he was trying to have them stop singing.
I also think that they aren't all the same, like they don't all have the same objectives.
Yeah.
Like they're some of them probably are in line with Regacia, some of them aren't.
I don't know, and only Robin doesn't look at this, but maybe my understanding so far, it's like the Unmade, they all have their own objective, but they're big enough to
I think kind of, yeah.
Yeah.
I mean, if there's siblings, there's not penalty in agreement.
I also didn't necessarily take what Stepengard said as gospel. I think if I would have come at him and said we left the Fire Forest intact, he would have been like, well, now how am I going to get supplies from Gate Pass? I think he was just...
Either way, he was going to be annoyed.
Also, this is another question. I have a quick question about the map, Justin.
Yep.
Does the path into Dasin go through Gate's Pass? So in other words, is Gate Pass between...
Not necessarily.
Oh, okay. So there's...
Let me pull this up.
I know. I looked at it and I was like, so really the Gregasians could just go to the fight through that pass at this point, right?
So I would also like to say that I do agree that the idea that madness is another part of Trillith, and I think that's a really good idea, but I don't think that we should discount madness being in reference to Stepengard either, though.
Sure. I mean,
we should be.
So
the capital M is pretty telling.
Sure. You know what? I'll give it, I'll stop saying 100%. I'll say 96%. There's a 4% chance that madness is...
4%.
I just don't want us to get so laser focused and then like forget.
No, I understand. I'm just pulling your leg. I'm just.
Yeah.
So, map for you, Ryan.
Let me see this stupid
gate
thing.
Pass over here is between Regesia and Shahalesti, technically.
Wait, where is
that's
it?
That's a path.
Roll 20.
Oh, there's roll 20. Oh, okay.
Yep.
Yeah.
Look at that. There it is.
You forgetting
I had the roll 20 open. I just, sorry, go ahead, Justin.
So that is where Gate Pass is. The Fire Forest was like here, roughly.
Yeah.
And then you guys right now, let me draw you a nice little
frozen they could have done
here.
It's like this. You see what I'm doing?
Yes, that's the path you took.
And here's where we are right now.
Yeah.
Over there.
Oh, we're over there.
Yep.
Oh, wow. That makes
sense.
What
about this right here?
That's pretty impassable. I know it looks... This is a stylized map here.
I'm sorry. Yeah, I get it.
Just make it more accurate map.
Yeah, so this one, the gray one is the Elidi Gap, basically, that you guys are trying to... That you're in right now. And then you got the Fire Forest over there in orange, which has kind of now opened up this weird little passage that comes from the north into the Fire Forest area and then down into the woods, basically.
So if they take Gate Pass, then they have a straight shot into Dasin. Another
straight
shot.
They
could try to go around it, but it'd be awkward because of those foothills and mountains that are around Gate Pass. The easiest way would be to go through Gate Pass, yes.
They might
be able to get smaller forces and things like this through the sides, but it'd be difficult to move an entire army past Gate Pass and not take it.
Mm-hmm. I see now. Okay.
I also want to say this ball sack looks way worse on this big map.
You mention it every single time we have the full map.
It's the little stuff. It's the little like notches.
It's a little nubbin.
Yeah, it's pretty rough. All right.
Looks like a drooping nipple.
Yeah, it looks like a boob.
A saggy,
one
saggy
boob. I don't know what that is on the side, but
I always thought that it looked like a overly excited witch face. Where she's got mouth open and cackling, and it's like a big nose.
Slightly more appropriate.
Oh, I see it now, yeah.
Like the ball sex or nose.
Lower jaw. And the mountains are almost her hat.
Yeah, and then you're
this is going to be great for our listeners, guys.
Ryan,
this map that we're looking at.
I don't see it.
I see it. Anyway, I would like to, with these orders in hand, we need to keep a hold of them for sure. I'll put them in the bag of holding for safekeeping. Wake up the guy and say, Sterling, I believe you had some questions for this one, as do I. And I will... I don't know what I'll do. I'll just get down. Like, I imagine he's sitting on his butt, like, hands behind him, back against the wall. I'm just going to walk up to him and just go, hey! Hey!
He doesn't like it.
I don't know if that works. Like, that's what I'm going to do.
I like how you just whined about us looking at stuff our viewers can't see and then pantomime something.
Yeah, you're right. All right, so I take him and shake him.
He's shaking him awake, yeah.
Yeah.
He groggily comes to.
Very warm greetings. Unfortunately, I have bad news. You were defeated, and we have captured you. So, in light of that, could you please inform me of the Inquisitor's name?
Why are your hands behind your back?
Me? Yeah, I had an itch on my butt.
Oh. I thought you were like...
It's an empathy. It's an empathy. It's in solidarity.
I have also been captured.
As I'm talking to you, my hands are behind my back. So, no.
He stares back at you. There's a slight grunt. That's all.
Tomorrow I can...
Pish.
Maybe have his own truth, but not today.
Well, that won't
what
make
did you do
smile.
With my men?
He smiles. That was fun.
What did you do with my men? Sorry, what did you do?
And women.
And women.
The important things. You know what happened to them.
Where are they?
Dead. Gone.
I'll turn from him.
Looks like you enjoyed it.
War is not for enjoyment.
I know we just met the two of you, but let's just be clear, we want to not kill him. We could use him, so
we need
good to know.
I think if either of you want to maybe break his nose or something, I go for it, but...
I'm very tapped out, though, so be careful.
I'm going to leave and start to just walk around the grounds, look for graves, I guess, or something.
Well, as you said, war is not for... honor for pleasure. In your case, what is it for then?
I do not need to explain myself to you.
No, you don't. But I'm still asking you.
And I am not answering.
Well, I don't believe we're going to get much more out of our friend, though. I would just like to share, sir, that us knowing the Inquisitor's name doesn't give us any kind of strategic benefit. It would just be nice to know. So if you could just meet me halfway. I will punch him in the face.
You punch him in the face. I want to roll for it. I don't have any clue how many hit points.
What you roll is going to be given to you and your fist.
Yeah, I'm sure that's true.
Break your wrist on his face.
I'm going to assume this would be like a strength check. Oh no, I rolled a 6. I think I go to punch him in the face, but I hit his helmet instead, and I'm like, ah! It's fine, we don't need to know her name. Goodness!
If you want him hurt, I can hurt him for you.
I don't think that's going to work with him.
No. But it would be fun.
What did he do when...
I hit him?
Took damage.
He just kind of turned his head a little and leaned into it.
He's not... Wait, you mean when Jack did it or before?
Jack. Oh. Yeah, Jack.
No real response.
Jack had the biggest response. Well, I don't believe we're going to get much more out of this fellow. So, since Bryn was able to heal us up a bit... And we know that there is a potential force coming to reinforce this position. I think it might make the most sense for us to make our way back to the Fend as soon as possible.
What's the weather out?
What's the weather like?
It's blustery, cold, and snowing.
And it's like 11 o'clock at night, right?
No, we got there at like 6 or 7, didn't we?
So we got to say
it's after sunset by this point in time, but it's not super late.
Yeah.
Can I tell if supplies were brought today? Like, are there still like unpacked crates?
Not really. The place is kept pretty clean for the most part. There's the mundane supplies, like I mentioned, including food down below. But it is not obvious to you whether or not supplies would have come today, tomorrow, whenever.
Does Bryn have her hut available or no spell slots? That's
a fantastic question.
Well, we do also know that...
It's an hour and a half to the next one?
It's about...
Hold on.
About 75 minutes of riding.
I say we can at least make it back to the last one.
I think we should make it all the way back to the Fend, as this prisoner that we have here is very valuable to protecting Gallows Land and rallying allies. I don't think we should risk having him out here in the dangerous gap any longer than we should.
I always have my hug because I can go ritually.
Right.
Are you suggesting we ride through the night?
Unfortunately, I think so.
Just wanted to be clear.
Does he have any weapons on him? Like in his pocket thing?
Would have taken anything.
Good question.
So he would have lost his weapon, his battle axe, and his short bow you can have if you want it, really, when you knocked him out initially.
I just want to make sure that he can't, like, hurt himself.
No, he does not have anything small that would be considered a weapon like that, no.
Can I search him for anything else?
Sure. He does have one potion of healing on him.
Oh, nice.
I will take that. Yeah, I'll stow that away.
The other one, if you recall, used during the battle.
Are there any other
potions? Also find one empty potion. There are no other ones that you can find.
Justin, do you know what identifying thing I could have off of a couple of these guys just from my notes, or do you want to
rip a couple of flames? They look like red flames, would be the decal, so to speak.
Okay.
The sewn in patch, you can say.
Well, we should leave soon then, if the others are content with returning tonight. I do not mind pushing back.
Sorry.
I was simply saying that I do not mind riding through the night if our destination is the Fend.
I guess I'm walking around looking for graves.
Clara, would you be comfortable leading us back? Is there anything in this gap that we should be wary of, like animals or anything like that? Because we really can't withstand a fight. And I can't cast my hut instantly. It would take me 10 minutes.
The concern for traveling at night is going to be safety. Cold. Not necessarily from animals, but from walking through mountain passes and stuff at night is going to get very difficult, especially for horses.
Mm-hmm. Sterling, we have to work together to make sure we're taking the right path.
Eventually, as you're kind of rounding the tower, Sterling, walking kind of through this deep drifts of snow, working your way around.
Can I say quick that I grabbed one of the swords from the orcish enemies as I was walking away from the group?
As you're walking around in the deep snows away around the tower, you kind of bump into something all of a sudden along the back wall on the far side, tucked around in between the tower and the canyon. And as you kind of unearth it a little bit, it is a pile of bodies. And tucked away, out of sight, and hidden by the snows.
I'll shake my head and I'll just take the sword and plant it in the ground. Like, firm, you know, stick it in the ground near there. And I'm going to just have to leave for now.
I'm going to actually go out and look for him once we're done talking inside.
Okay. He's not that difficult to find. You follow the footprints in the snow.
Did you find what you were looking for?
Fortunately, I did.
I'm sorry. Pain to lose. Pain to lose good men.
Yeah, they were good men indeed. I'll try to force a smile, but it definitely looks pained. You know, like as he's breathing in. Yeah.
That did look painful.
Thank you.
How many years have you been fighting?
Been fighting 15 years. How about yourself?
Oh, goodness. About 100 now. Well, give or take.
Then, you surely know more about the pain of loss than I do.
Perhaps. That's only because I've felt more. Doesn't mean I've figured my way around it any better.
Yeah,
I can't say it gets better.
If it gets easier.
If anything, after this long, you become a little numb to it, which is a downside from what I've seen.
Sterling, make an insight check for me.
Four. I'm definitely too. Yeah.
Don't worry about it.
He's
not crying, but you could tell that, like, he's
not focused.
I guess not focused is the right way to put it. Maybe he's even a little less sad now that Myetharia is paying attention to him, I guess. So what did she ask him, though?
I was just saying it's not a bad thing to feel all the pain. And I wouldn't I wouldn't recommend becoming numb to everything. It doesn't solve anything. Having people around you, having friends, not forgetting happiness. That's what I would recommend.
So we've only known each other for a couple days now, but the way you fight with your friends and the way they fight for you, I don't see the numbness. I think you feel a lot more than you let on, Myetharia. Tharia. Damn it.
The throwback.
You're playing Sterling right now, not Rayla.
I know. I've been trying very hard to say it correctly, too. Because I know
it's
that
always Ryan.
Myetharia. Yeah, it's always Ryan, unfortunately. Myetharia.
No. No, I certainly feel more than I let on. You've guessed that right. I just don't like it. I don't like feeling all the pain.
Yeah.
Nobody does, I think.
Yeah, I hear you there. I'll just give her, like, you know, kind of a squeeze on her shoulder, and then move towards the,
where Myetharia the goes down.
Well, I also, we're both like probably.
No, I actually heal.
We got healing. We got healing. We're good. We're good. I'll follow.
Yeah. So, what's the plan?
Yeah, as they come back in, I'll ask everyone to weigh in on whether we should go tonight and ride through, or just go back to the nearest outpost and sleep there. I vote go all the way through.
This was only one day, right? From outpost to outpost?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
I say go back to the one and sleep there.
I think that's Stephanie talking.
Well, I can take you all the way.
I almost died. Oh, Candy, you can't see.
What just happened?
just an eyebrows happened.
what did Clara say?
My wife behind me saying, "I can take you all the way," was what shot up my eyebrows.
Oh,
Clara's voice.
Like, and we're done for tonight.
I can take you all the way.
Yeah, guys, we're gonna call it there. It's been a great session.
Gross.
Myetharia, Bryn, Sterling, what do you think?
I'm willing to go back to the Fend, but it's a long night. I'm also fine with just going back to the last outpost.
If Myetharia can do it, then I think I can do it. I know it's tough keeping up with her, but I'd at least like to put my skills to the test there. My endurance.
I see what you're doing, and I don't like it.
That wasn't that suggestive.
No.
Just on the follow-up of the previous one, it certainly was.
Yeah. Come on.
And also if things become too treacherous, we can at least
stop at another
outpost, or use you could put up the hut. The hut.
Yeah. Just
we might have to huddle all the horses in with us, which might be snug.
Oh, yeah.
Really,
they won't fit.
They won't.
We'll just have frozen horses in the morning, so probably not the best idea.
Well,
we can get healing at each of the outposts too.
Yeah.
Sounds like we're gonna mount up and make our way back to the Fend.
As the mom of the group, we should rest, but I agree with at least getting to the next outpost so we're not here in case the supply drop comes.
How about this? We just see how hard it is to get to the outpost, and if it's the worst, then we'll stop.
Yeah.
Okay. You guys pick up the remaining horses, some of the ones that were left down below, some of the ones that you guys brought with you. Mount back up. What are you doing with the orc?
You should probably
lay him on the back of a horse.
You can, but it's going to start making it difficult for that horse.
Red Dead Redemption style.
Ours is the smallest, so we don't have a railing for him to ride with.
Tie a rope around him and
dragon. No, he would die.
I'm fairly
light.
You don't
have any other extra horses?
He could ride on. Oh, hey! I will sit down and say, I've got this. And I will ritual cast
thingy. Yeah,
a spell that I've never gotten to use. Tensor's floating disc. And, I will summon this disc that rises up out of the ground, and it's like icy blue, and we're able to set the body onto there and then bring him with us, and he rides right behind me.
How fast does it move?
I think it moves as fast as I do. But we're not going to be running regardless, so...
Yeah, we're going to be taking it slow. You're right.
It stays 20 feet behind you.
Yep. So I would recommend that I ride somewhere towards the middle with our friend behind me and then someone else behind him to make sure there's no funny business.
Yep. Sounds good. I'll take it.
It's going to be 20 feet behind you. There's no controlling that.
Right.
Well, I imagine Clara and I will be in the front. And then Jack, and then Sterling and Myetharia in the back.
Mm-hmm. Okay. As you guys travel, then, I would like for either Bryn or Clara, then, as the leaders, to make a survival check. You're going to make it straight roll, because it'd normally be at disadvantage because of the hour. But because of helping each other,
together,
you get it back to a straight.
Before we go...
I'm going to go meta. What's your... What's your modifier, Cassie?
four.
All right, I'll give your guidance.
And I will also, if Clara's going to lead us, I'll walk up to Clara and I'll put my hand on her shoulder and say, this may be difficult, but you led us here very well before, and we trust you as one of us. And I will give her my last bardic inspiration. That's it.
Okay. Go ahead and make a survival check.
Ooh, where'd you go?
You got a D4 too.
And a D8 if you want.
15 plus 3. Let's see. How long does the bardic inspiration last? 10 minutes?
Yeah.
So I might as well use it, right?
Yeah, just throw it in.
So.
Plus 3.
I'm not going to take the plus 3, because I think a 10-minute lasting inspiration on a skill check for the next 75 minutes doesn't make any sense.
Okay.
Because, like, something that doesn't last long enough, and even I think the guidance doesn't help it either, because that's only 1 minute.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, just, I see. Wow.
I guess if you're constantly having one hand attached to her...
Guidance.
Spam casting guidance. I was already giving you credit for helping by giving her advantage. I should take away the advantage if I'm going to let you use guidance, I think. Because then you'd be no longer concentrating on helping.
That's fair.
Okay. I've seen 18. Makes sense.
So, yeah, I think we're just going to take the one. 18 is... It's difficult for you, Clara. But you're able to follow your path back for now. As the snow hasn't drifted too much yet, you're able to follow the path that you guys had already carved a little bit through the through there, and it kind of gives you some helpful hints on your way back. As such, you're able to make it back to the previous outpost without incident.
Can I say one? Never mind, I can't.
It is getting more difficult each time, though, as it has been longer since you've been there, and the snow has accumulated more to wipe out your path. And so you're going to be going more and more blind back down.
How many more outposts are there?
There are... Three, you're four. Going back five. Five total, so four more.
Yep.
And then to the fend.
Yeah. Can going to the next one, can we all get healed up?
They don't have a ton of healing, but they can give you some at least. You know what? I'm not gonna worry about it. Yes, you can get healed up.
Completely healed up?
Sure. That should tell you you're probably not likely to get ambushed at least.
Okay.
So you can make it back to the previous outpost, walk back up, knock on the door, so to speak, talk to the guards once more. It's only been a couple of hours since you guys were there. You're a little bit worse for the wear now, and they can comment on it. But they will basically exchange back your horses that you gave them previously on the previous leg of the journey, and they are able to keep them fresh for you a little bit more.
And we warn them that they are now the lead outpost.
Yep. They understand not to expect anything from further ahead, and they will be a little bit more on alert, watching for stuff.
Yeah, I was going to say, I think we should let them know about the
supply drop.
2-day supply drops, yeah.
Yep, especially watching for wyverns.
Yes, watch the skies, not just the lands.
Do you have anything that would make it easier for us to travel in the dark?
That voice shift was so good.
Do you have anything for us to travel easier?
Nope, sorry, I don't really have anything for you. I hate to say it.
What are we doing for survival?
Yep.
What is survival? Is that
wisdom?
Wisdom? Well, if we are going to try again, I'll happily help you out, Clara. Do we think that we should continue?
Well, we might as well just keep going and then we can't anymore. We can hunt up, right?
Love it.
Shut up or hut up. Nut up or hut up. Okay, well, if we're going to try again, I will walk up to you, Clara, and I will pull out my diviner and blow a sweet melody that fills you with inspiration. I'm casting Enhance Ability, and I'll give you Owl's Wisdom. What?
Owls. I was just saying owls.
Oh, I thought you said ouch. Yeah. I'll give you Owl's Wisdom, which will give you advantage. Oh, wait, but she was already going to get advantage from Bryn.
No, she has a straight roll from me.
She was giving you advantage, yep.
So we can't double advantage.
Well, I mean, you can, but it doesn't do anything.
All right, never mind. Just want to use my spells, guys. Just want to use my spells. That's fine.
Okay. Well, you guys continue on. Back down to the next outpost. Go ahead and make another survival check.
You got this.
If you would please, Sterling and Myetharia, make a perception check.
Natural one.
And actually, make it at disadvantage.
Oh no, it's straight.
Make the perception check at disadvantage?
Yep.
Even though I have dark sight?
Oh, sorry. Sorry, Sterling. Yes, even though you have dark sight.
Even if I give them my dark vision?
I'm trying to find
you
a stat board,
first of all.
See if I can find it.
Shut up, Jess. No. I could have.
No.
You don't have
no reason to.
Because it's dark.
That's 6 total.
It only lasts an hour.
True.
6 total.
Okay. So,
I rolled a 13, but
Wisdom.
Sorry, what's the wisdom modifier there, Cassie?
Oh, you just can't find it at all.
Yeah,
it's plus one.
14. Alright, I found it. 14.
Okay.
Oh.
Just watching the orc instead.
So, Clara, with the natural one, unfortunately, you don't notice a huge cliff that's in front of you guys as a rather decently sized cliff as you guys are kind of going along, and like lemmings, the bunch of you go ahead and make animal handling checks and make them at disadvantage.
Everybody
Hey, everybody.
I don't like this.
get away.
Oh, no.
Disadvantage.
I rolled so bad.
Disadvantage.
Oh, it didn't matter. I got the exact same number.
One of mine was 19, but I also got a 6.
Three, 7, 11.
Okay, so Bryn, you're the only one who avoids this, as the rest of them go plummeting down this little slipping slope, kind of falling off their horses. Each of you guys will take a little bit of damage on the way, and also as it's starting to get late and getting past. Oh, 2 points, wonderful. 2 points damage. As it's starting to get really late, you guys are getting tired. It's getting difficult. It's almost impossible to follow this trail. Everyone who failed that actually gains a point of exhaustion.
Okay, maybe now we pushing should stop.
Past 10 hours of travel along with the fight in the middle.
That was just a scratch.
It was just a scratch, as it turned out.
As soon as we land, I'm going to spin around and make sure that the Regassian's still on my floating disc.
Well, your disc is empty. But fortunately, Sterling has noticed that he had escaped and fallen off prior to this slipping, and was able to scramble up and grab him and recollect him before he was able to make it in any distance away from you guys.
Okay.
MVP.
Good save, Sterling.
Yeah, so I grab him by the scruff of his neck and toss him back onto the tensor's disc.
Wait, did I take exhaustion too, even though
No, you did not, because you succeeded.
Okay. You wouldn't last out there without us, not in this weather. Just to stay with us.
You notice that he hasn't gotten his bindings off, but he had rolled off just prior to the fall that you guys took, basically. Unfortunately, he rolled a 13 for stealth, and Sterling rolled a 14 to find him.
Ace.
Whoa.
As he landed deep into the snow, trying to hide from you guys, but Sterling was able to locate him and retrieve him quickly.
How far did we get?
You're about halfway to the next outpost at this point in time, but you can keep going.
Let's push through. Let's get there.
Let's just get to the next outpost.
Yeah, I won't make you roll another one for between each outpost. Like, there's one between each outpost. It represents the journey through that whole section.
Right.
So after another 75 minutes of riding, as we are now... We're really getting up there in the time of horseback. You're at 600 minutes in the saddle, so 10 hours of saddle time.
Ouch.
Through the pass.
Is it basically a straight shot? Or is there a lot of, like...
Roughly, but there's, little... like, back and forth, like, climbs and descents. It's not like a... well-defined highway through the mountain.
Yeah, yeah, I understand.
It's not like Gates.
Gates' passes is precious.
Okay. You can go back to Jack saying Myetharia all the time at the beginning of this campaign.
Just did it as much as Ryan did.
That's Raylan's accent. You're making fun of his accent. You can't help that.
Yeah,
that's racist.
Racist. Halfling. It's a hard word in halfling.
I'll let you guys make it up to the next outpost.
Okay.
You gonna keep kinda going?
Collapse once we get inside there. No.
No, it's time to rest.
Is there a cell we could put that dude in?
Well, there's not a cell. They can keep him in the barracks and have the door closed. There's many others who are on
guard.
Yeah, they have a rotation for the tower itself anyway, so... It wouldn't be that unreasonable for them to have somebody be able to watch the man for the next 8 hours as well.
What's the process for sending a message back to Gallo's Fend?
The chaplains all have the ability to do so.
I'm assuming we maybe ask the chaplain to send back a message.
They're about the same time as we will.
No.
I mean, they all have sending.
Okay.
So they can send a message to Gallo at any moment.
So there should be a message sent back and
agreed.
Just letting him know that we've succeeded.
We've got the goods.
recapturing outpost number 6 and yeah, the goods.
There is effectively a response of good, get back here. That's the rough upshot. I don't feel like going word for word on it.
I mean, that's all works. That's all I would expect.
Yeah.
That's all I would expect. So let's rest as little as we need to and get back on the road.
Sure. Normal night's rest for you guys.
Light outside.
You guys get a night's rest. You can take a long rest on your character sheets.
I'm gonna check in with Bryn before we go to sleep. See if she has any more spells.
No.
No. You would just say that. Even if did.
Well, I have 2 first levels, but whatever you want is not first level.
No, it's all right. Then once I'm done with her, I'm gonna go in and check in with Jack briefly. Just find him before we sleep and can just put a hand on his shoulder and how are you doing?
Huh?
Where's the...
Sorry, I'm talking to my wife, not you. Where's what?
The long rest.
It's the campfire.
Oh.
I had to just find it too. Sorry. You said you put your hand on Jack's shoulder and say,
how are you doing?
How are you doing?
Well, I'm a bit chilled to the bone, but we were successful, and that's great.
Yes, we were. See, the last thing I saw before Bryn carried me over the wall was you as the gorilla smashing to death the wyvern. Well done.
Yes, and then I ripped it in half and threw both halves away. It was quite something.
Yes, that's... Despite... I'm not even going to touch on the matter of you changing into a gorilla. That's new.
Hmm. Yes, it is.
But, is this violent streak attached to the, change in characteristics, or did we talk about
yes. It? Well, I have never turned into something so aggressive before, so I think that possibly just the very characteristic, almost like pantomiming, brought me more into the mindset of the beast than I expected.
I see. But you are yourself now, and you remember everything that you have done, even though you did it as that creature. So?
Yeah, I do. Yes. I also defeated a few of the Regessians, and I feel as though my battle prowess may have increased recently, and feel like I'm able to do more for the group, and that feels really good.
Yes, you certainly helped us today. Without you and Bryn, all the healing you two did, we would not have made it.
Yes, we did. I did healing as well. That is true.
You'll remember to come talk to me if you need to, right?
Yes, of course. Thank you for reminding me. Are you okay? Do you need to talk?
No, I'm doing quite fine. Do I believe him that he's doing all right, or is he just kind of putting up a demeanor of, ooh, we got this, we did it, haha, great job, guys.
Pretty consistent with Jack's character, but...
I mean, well, yeah. But does it seem like he's kind of putting up a facade?
Rob, would you like her to roll, or...?
Sure. You can roll.
I'll make insight check.
As I tell my players, I'm either rolling a persuasion check or a deception check. Oh, you don't know which.
It hit the D4, and it stopped rolling on a 1.
That's good. So, I didn't roll very well either, but...
Yeah. Well, hang on. Well, it's an auto fail, right?
I'm always so tempted to disinformation on bad rolls.
A 5. That. Still a 5.
I rolled a 13. Oh, still pretty bad for me, but...
All right, I'll take his word for it then. All right,
I'm going to go get some sleep. I'm exhausted.
Thank you for checking in, Myetharia. I really appreciate it. You're a good friend, and I'm glad that you're with us and didn't go with Rayland and Winry. I don't know what I would do without you being nearby.
Yes, no, I don't think I could let you out of my sight. I mean, I would have died today if it hadn't been for you, of course. So thank you again for saving my life. Even if you also, were a gorilla, or whatever that was.
I'm also quite endearing.
Oh, yes. So charming, so endearing, so heartwarming, so... Yes, yes. All of those things, dear. Go get yourself some rest.
I'm like asleep before you leave.
Is this
that's how like it... sing off all the characteristics? He's like, yes, yes, yes.
Yep.
Is this whole conversation taking place in like Jack's room? Like, do we all have private rooms here?
Or wherever like, we are, I'll just walk over to him.
Hanging out in the barracks. You're taking up some of the unused beds right now.
Okay, so we're all in the area.
Yeah, the relative area.
Yes. I just walked over and tied to him, and
then you walk to your own bed, like a couple of meters away, where we're all...
Yes, yes, meters.
Oh, okay.
Feet.
A couple of feet away. okay. Then,
you probably would have heard some of the conversation, if that's what you're insinuating.
Yeah, yeah. Well, I was dropping eaves.
Dropping eaves.
But if everyone's there, then I will just... log it away. Although I am watching, so but you know what? I think you told the whole story and the things you said and the actions. So let's move on. For now.
Okay.
I have no idea.
Before I start my trans, I'm gonna tell Puck to keep an eye on the prisoner, and if anything happens, to come get me.
Sure, no problem. What I will say, and this can be for everybody so we can kind of speed up, he literally cannot get out of the ropes. He cannot roll high enough to break what Myetharia rolled to tie him up.
He rolled really well.
Well, just 25.
I was gonna say, wasn't all no 26. It wasn't all 26, my credit. Sorry. I rolled an 18 with advantage, and I had guidance. So, it wasn't all on me.
So, just to make it a little easier, he can try to roll away or something like this, but he cannot get out of the bonds.
He'd have died outside by himself.
He might have. Yeah. He's willing to try it.
Yep.
Oh, I didn't level up yet. So well, after this in the rest, morning.
In the morning, you guys, I'm gonna hold on to it just because it's gonna make more story sense here in a moment. You guys spend the first half of the day basically heading back down from the outposts. It's much easier in the daylight. There's no driving snow anymore today. There's still a little bit of a wind in the gap, but it's much pleasant traveling weather for you guys on the way back down. As such, it is very simple for you guys to make it to the bottom. I don't need you guys to slow down, take any checks, anything like this on the way back down. And a little bit after noon, kind of 1 o'clock timeline, you guys make it back down out of the Alidi Gap, and you can start to see the river.
Wait, though, can I have one quick
absolutely
RP moment
you can.
While we're riding?
You guys are in the back, so the two of you together watching out for the
order.
Both of you to assume that he wants to talk to me, Justin.
And
wow.
Jack is far enough ahead.
I mean,
Jack's at least 20 feet ahead of you.
Yep. Yeah. Plus, you probably a little bit back from the disc, so probably 40, 50 feet back.
Yeah.
Yeah. So I'll sidle up and just say, so you and Jack, huh?
What?
Well, I don't know. You guys just were talking like you had a close relationship last night.
Well, I suppose we do. We are good friends.
Just friends?
No. Jack's too good for me. I do admit that there was a time...
I don't see that.
There was a time when I first met him where I thought he was sweet, but he's too good for me and I'm not good enough for him. I gave up on that years ago.
I don't see how anybody could be too good for you, Myetharia.
That's sweet of you. But no. Well, I'm a little too rough for him. He deserves better than me.
Maybe it's just that I was born and raised in Gallows Fend, but I don't think you're too rough. I think you fit right in here among the warriors, Dassin. And I don't know, maybe even find yourself being one of the most prettiest lasses in this area, even. Scariest, too. Your work with a blade, with both of your blades, something else.
Well, you sure do know how to make a girl blush, Sterling.
Is she actually blushing, though? Like, for real?
I'd say she has, like, a slight hint, but nothing, like, nothing too serious. it does seem like quite a strong city you have here, but when this is all over, I have to return to my own home, Gate Pass.
Yeah.
They need help there. You all don't need help here. You're strong warriors here.
Well, but I don't know what's going to happen the next couple of days. I don't think that your time in the Fend is over after we get back with our prisoner and the information, but I sure hope that I get to see you around just a little bit before you leave.
You'll see me.
With that, I'll kind of like drop back a little bit, like pretending like I saw something, maybe just like, it's like I'll
separate a little bit.
I'll just like nod and like separate a little bit. Yeah.
Give him a little nod, yeah.
After a few hours.
I ride forward a little bit and I'm like, Clara, that armor looks great on you. No, I'm just kidding.
after a few hours.
It does.
I love her so much. Oh god.
It does.
After a few hours.
And then she quickly take the reins and like go ahead a little bit. Distance herself for a bit.
Damn straight it does.
She don't need no fuckboys in her life.
A couple hours down the road, down the path, you guys are able to see Gallows Fend once more and make your way back to where you began. When you return with your prisoner and with your evidence, you are immediately ushered into a conference chamber at the castle. While chaplains tend to any wounds that you may still have, which you probably don't, which you may have from the final journey, and make sure that you kind of fussed over, everybody cleaned up, looking good, this sort of thing. You're assured that groom's at work, making sure the horses are tip-top shape, everybody's all good once more. Inside the conference chamber, did you really? Oh, man.
I did, actually, yeah. No, I know we're on a horse. I'm going to use the word sidle.
inside the conference chamber, Duke Gallo and an assortment of commanders and advisors are looking at what looks to be a table map depicting Gallo's lands as a topographical model, like 3D hills. As you kind of walk in, you hear snippets of their conversation. They're kind of discussing ways to slow down Steppenguard's advance. There's a human advisor, and he says that he's in favor of ordering Pitchwood Burg, which you may or may not have heard of before, but it's a small town in Dashkaban's territory on the banks of the Nasham River. And he's kind of saying that he'd be in favor of ordering them to spread this year's harvest of pitch over large sections of the river and ignite it in order to melt the river, forcing them to split around, slow them down, give them more time. You hear someone else argue, this would financially cripple them. They're devastating for the people of Pitchwood, even if we could convince them to do it. And Gala then says, shh, we have visitors. Hear us. What is your news?
Well, you can ditch the melting the ice idea because we have here a prisoner, and I kind of indicate I'm sure he's with us, who will go quite a long ways to convince Dashkaban and Timor to side with us.
Prisoner would be very difficult to get from here to both of them.
Indeed. I have patches also.
It would be easier to signify true plot.
The papers.
We do, actually.
Show them
I'll
the papers,
pull from the bag of holding, so I'll open up my robe and I'll reach in and I'll just start pulling out the reams of paper of the orders. Just be like, and that.
No, they're not reams. There's like a handful of papers, though.
Oh, okay.
Take one at a time. One.
I pull out a hanky and kind of pull it like that, and then.
He kind of he nods, smiles, this sort of thing. He says, I do not think that taking the orc with you would be a good choice. We will keep him in the cells here. Be too much of a pain for you to keep with. Especially for the speed that you will require. And while the patches okay. may be interesting, they don't prove anything on their own. The orders are really the important piece here.
So you're sending us then?
Well, you are the easiest, you are the best, you are the fastest, and I need my soldiers here to defend, if at all possible.
How far is that to?
I know that Steppengard is on his way. I know that we have some time, but not an infinite amount, and we need to be building our defenses. Since this is your information that you were able to find, I hope that I can trust you to make the journeys. To rally my allies to our defense.
But will they trust us not knowing us versus a message from you?
Do not think a message will be enough on its own, though we will do our best to communicate with them as well if you're coming. They will not be shocked or surprised. They'll know what to look for, but they will want to see this themselves.
And this is player knowledge, but you guys did actually make an appearance at the court, so you can assume that they wrote back or were
they
like
know us.
Yeah, they experienced that whole thing, so they know a little bit, right? That's like,
so if it goes bad, it could go very bad.
Well, but you know that couriers out of Bresk were not exactly the easiest thing to do at the moment.
Fair enough.
Mm, that's true. Not important enough for them to send a message, message them to.
Yeah, I was about to say, I figured though that like,
I don't think.
Yeah. Anyway, maybe, the magical. Yeah. Well,
maybe.
Gallo,
I said, it's possible.
Gallo, has anyone else arrived? Anyone else from Bresk? Like, there's others of our group. Rayland, a halfling, and Winry. She's Tabaxi. You couldn't miss her.
None that I have heard to this point, no. But what I can say is, you can escort my proxy, or, well, my replacement proxy. I've heard that Jinnis has been indisposed of. He kind of says with a cough.
Spoilers.
His name is Moccasin, which sounds hilarious, by the way.
I thought it was Roger.
That's not his proxy. He's just a servant.
Oh, yeah, it's just like a footman.
Moccasin. Moccasin. We'll do a moccasin, so it's not quite like the shoe.
Uh-huh.
If you can, first
take him. I
like how it's
Roger, Mike, and moccasin.
Right. I would recommend first to Lord Dashkaban, second to Lady Timor, though it is of your choice, one way or the other.
I agree.
Either way,
Timor is north, right?
As I'm sure you heard us discussing, the village of Pitchwood is directly in between. I leave it up to you. I leave it to your choice. I will not force them to do anything.
Do you advise that we leave? I would assume as soon as possible. When do you advise that we leave?
as soon as you can, as soon as you're available. We only have so much time.
There is no time to waste.
Myetharia, I can... We haven't spoken to them in a while. I can message Rayland and Winry. If they're on their way, maybe they can meet us.
Technically, we haven't heard from them since they were in prison, so we don't know that they got out.
Yeah, but this is Bryn being, just being positive.
Oh, they didn't? They don't know that we got out?
Because we
didn't message us again.
That's true.
Because it was the day that we left the Fend, and we forgot to do it.
Yeah, and we were gone all day yesterday.
Yeah,
it's not that we forgot, it's that we've been saving spells to do our job.
Resources, yeah.
I asked her last time, I'm like, do you have any spells? Not sending.
Well, what I can tell you, getting to Dashkaban territory, to his castle, will not be too difficult, though you do have a choice of either going through the pitchwood itself, the forest between here and there, or you can go around it. It'll be slower to go around, but you won't have to deal with the Fae. The pitchlings of Pitchwood Forest are notoriously unwelcoming to guests, so take that as you will.
We didn't have a great experience last time we went through a forest. We also have the potential of going over it. How wide is the Pitchwood?
Pitchwood itself is miles upon miles. It is, let me do a quick measurement, about 20 to 25 miles deep.
What do you mean by over it, Jack?
He means Tabaxi.
I mean Tabaxi and myself.
Oh, yourself. I forgot about you.
Mine only lasts an hour. But yeah. Potentially on certain situations, I might be able to cast it twice. Just so you know.
Well, perhaps if you're speaking of fly, there might be a more suitable use for it for later on.
To get over the
quickest way to get from Dashkaban to Timor's lands is to scale the Glasskeel Cliffs. A flight would be easier than scaling.
It's good to know.
So
this would also allow you to bypass the long winding roads around, which will no doubt be blockaded.
So we ride hard to Dashkaban, then ride back around to the cliffs and just use the fly to get over the cliffs. Very long trip. I feel like Steppengard will get to you before we're able to reach them.
Scouts indicate. Let me look at the timeline document.
Breaking my immersion.
My scouts indicate that we have roughly 8 days. It could be longer if there was some distraction. I would hazard a guess that mobilizing and moving any armies here will take multiple days for Timor and Dashkaban, so the sooner that you can get to them, the better the chances and the better the numeric quantity of reinforcements would be.
What if Braylon and Winry met us at Dashkaban's?
Well, that's what we're going to theoretically
find out. And could the three of us ride on Tabaxi?
You did before, just barely.
Oh, that's right.
Yeah.
So then, taking the route of the mountain cliffs via flight would be the fastest and most easily accessible for us.
But since you have limited flight, we would probably need to get to the cliffs first and then take flight over it.
Tabaxi doesn't have a limit.
Yeah, but you do.
If the three of us can run a Tabaxi, I don't need to do anything.
Four now, as you are going to be escorting a proxy.
Oh, right.
That's true.
Shit.
Ooh. More difficult to do any flight then, because if we potentially, say, have Rayland and Winry, then we'd have six people. Well, five if Jack is a bird. to three on one and two on the other. That isn't too difficult, but...
Yeah.
Yeah, we've done that before.
Polymorph only lasts an hour.
And you could only do it once. Oh, do you get another spell slot when we level up?
Yeah. Rayland, 2 hours, potentially.
Your bird wouldn't make it all the way there.
Yeah.
You made it most of the way there. But that would have been the full time of flying, so no, you would not be at the fend yet.
I guess... 1 hour of rest for 3 hours of flying. Okay. I'm reading it right now.
I guess let's go. And Myetharia, I can message... Regardless, I'm going to message Rayland and Winry to update them. I hope they're okay.
As I said, they're strong. I'm sure they're doing just fine.
Mr. Gallo, where would you like Sterling and I stationed?
You stay here. Stay at the fend. Let the heroes do their job at this point. They can escort the proxy without you. We need your arms.
I'll nod and get back to my regular seat.
I miss her already.
Bye, Clara. I hate to see you go, but I love to watch you leave.
She doesn't say goodbye.
Just
no, I'll look slightly disappointed, but nod and make my way out and say, "Well, I hope to see you guys around before you head." Well, I suppose you're heading out soon, so we'll meet again.
Meet again. Just kind of lock eyes with him and give him a smirk.
I'll nod and leave them to it.
So sad I missed this.
Well, the three of you with your escort, the proxy. Would you like to head out?
Yeah, I guess.
You want Jack, should we...
Yeah, you gotta do ascending, I think, right?
Go ahead and make your sending if you'd like to.
She's got to think about what to say. So what were you saying, Myetharia?
Oh, I'm like, oh, there it is. Were we going to potentially look into some armor for Bryn?
I don't think just yet.
Yeah, I think the upshot was all the blacksmiths are too busy preparing for the attack. They can't really help us right now.
Yep, correct.
All right. Couldn't quite recall what the conclusion was. Thank you.
If you want to be general with your message, I'm totally fine with it.
Okay. How are you? We're headed back south to gain allies. Do you need help?
I'm going to fill in some details for Rayland and Winry here.
I've been curious where we're at.
Rode the rock for the full day that you could, as much as you could, before it got too exhausted. You had to land, rest, recuperate, this sort of thing. As you continued on afterwards the next day, you passed through a village first on your way out. This village called Pitchwood Burg that we just heard of. And a couple of hours down the road from there, that's when you get the message from Bryn. Asking how you guys are, where are you at, this sort of thing. You would still be on foot at this point as the rock is gone, and rough estimates, which you may or may not know, you're still probably 3 or 4 days on foot away from Gallows Fend.
Can I get pedantic for a second though? Because I've been reading the feather token rock thing, and it says 144 miles. That's how far.
Right.
So, if you're flying, I mean, I just looked at, Gallows Fend, I mean, is about 100 miles
from here. I thought I looked this up at one point and you weren't going to make it. Now you're making me doubt it.
Yeah, it says 120 miles on the map here. So I would understand if we haven't like made it all the way there yet, because it's a full day of traveling that it says. So it's like 8 hours worth of traveling. You can get, so let's see, it says 16 miles per hour or something. You have to travel for 3 hours and then rest an hour. I don't remember what time of day it was either that we escaped. I mean, if it was nighttime, then we're flying through the night, and that's probably difficult too. So maybe
it was nighttime. But regardless, then you would have arrived at the Fen this morning.
Boy, I could have gotten there at the
same time.
I looked into this, and you were going to make it like 2/3 of the way there.
You did. I don't remember what you looked at though.
Neither do I.
Yeah, so
maybe I just did it based off of rock feather? Itself, as opposed to from the feather token.
Yeah, so I did rock, feather token, bird. Token disappears, enormous multicolored bird, has the statistics of a rock, but it obeys your simple commands, can't attack, it can carry up 500 pounds, flying 16 miles per hour, maximum of 140.
As you guys are leaving the city... You see in the distance, coming over the horizon, this flapping, large, gigantic bird. Just as you're sending the message.
Yeah.
Rayland, your head.
Can I land the bird? Can I land the bird? And I'm gonna land the bird next to them. I'll see them respond. Land the bird. And I'll say, "Where are you going?"
I'll run over and give him a big hug.
The bird disappears underneath your legs.
we drop to the ground. Do I have to roll to like land on my feet?
Absolutely not. You're way too cool for that.
She can hug. He's stiff at first, but then he softens. Mm.
I'm sprinting up to Winry, just like, "You're okay!
Rayland, we made it! We made it!" And then I will hug Jack and start sobbing.
Oh, no!
When she starts crying, I'll go hug her, too.
I'll just slowly walk up to the group. "Well, look at the pair of you."
Oh man, such good dichotomy.
No, I didn't think we'd get to see you two again.
Bryn, you can notice when you set Rayland back down again that he kind of limps a little bit. He kind of favoring one leg slightly.
Trying to hide it, but it probably isn't.
She's astute at this sort of thing. She has a medical healer. Point of view.
Of course.
Happened to you.
You were going to say degree at first.
Yeah.
She has a medical degree after all.
Well, Stephanie wouldn't notice that shit.
Shut up. Yeah, masters. Raylan, what happened? And I'll kneel down and start looking at his knee and feeling around.
As far as you can tell, the knee looks whole, looks solid.
Well, probably feels... wouldn't it feel like there's some stuff missing in there?
If she, like, picked up your leg and wibbled it back and forth, like you see they do to athletes all the time when they're testing, like, their ACL joint and this sort of thing, then you could probably feel the difference in resistance. Just poking it from the outside while you're standing on it, probably can't tell.
Yeah, I probably have my rogue leather knee pads or whatever on. I don't know what shin guards. I don't whatever.
Sure, you do what you want.
So
just canon that Raylan always has knee pads on.
Oh, it makes it easy to do awesome knee slides.
I'll win
other stuff too.
And I'll say, it was. Couple of close calls in there.
They took him and he didn't come back and I think they took something from his leg. Bryn, help!
And then I'll sort of grab onto her arm and then just look at Rayland with a terribly sad look on my face. I'll fix it. I don't think I can do it now, but I'll fix it.
Well, it's not that bad.
I'll start looking over Winry and be like, did they take something out of you? Are you okay? Like, feeling her leg, like, are you okay?
For what it's worth, Myetharia, you're not walking. Your
horse is, if you want to take them. I said that as a jest. You still haven't picked up on Mathari's humor yet. Or that she has any.
Just wanted to make sure there wasn't a misunderstanding.
No.
Well, with everybody back together again, go ahead and level up to level 8.
Yay!
And while you're doing it, go ahead and also make a roll for feat training.
Oh, I'm so nervous. The dice have sucked tonight.
Boy.
Mine's gonna...
I was totally going to have them meet you at Pitchwoodburg instead of here, but I don't.
Yeah, I was going to say, when you said they were just outside of Pitchwoodburg, I was like, Ryan's just digging a hole. We're just going to have to turn right back around and go right back to where they are.
Oh, see, I can't. I don't know. You got to level up. What do I take?
You didn't put any thought into this?
No.
Adding.
Winry, you
negative one.
What?
Oh my gosh.
Investigation.
Yeah, you were rolling for investigation skill proficiency. So you'd be rolling.
Hey, nice.
You're rolling intelligence, I think it is, for investigation?
Yes.
So whatever your intelligence modifier is.
What gives me more AC?
The 10 total for you?
Uh-huh.
Okay. You're most of the way there, but you're not there yet. Myetharia, yours would be dexterity if you wanted to continue working on what you were working on solo.
Please. Awesome. What do I add, Justin?
Yours would be... I'll let you choose between intelligence, wisdom... Yeah, intelligence or wisdom.
Okay.
And mine probably intelligence, actually. I think it's probably best for you.
20.
Very nice. Good progress.
Yeah, I rolled 18.
Ooh, my save DC went up. That's nice.
Sorry, it's an intelligence check then, right?
Effectively, yes.
Okay.
Yeah, not a saving throw.
Oh, I don't know why I asked. They're the same.
That doesn't change anything.
Myetharia, dexterity.
Yes. Is this post leveling up or pre?
Either is fine. Post is fine. If you want to put in your ASIs first and get plus one, you can do it.
I hadn't completely decided yet on if I was going to go double dex improvement or not. But I rolled a natural 20 for once. So pre-leveling up, it's just dex, I think, plus four. So at least 24 if I do the...
you tell me afterwards if I add one to it.
Okay.
It probably won't 18. Make any difference to one way or the other. But yours is 18.
Yeah.
You're getting close.
It's wisdom, right?
Yep, yours would be wisdom. And Rayland, if you would like to still roll for the coordination with Myetharia that you were working on, about half of the time, or a little bit more, would have been with her anyway. So I am totally fine with you having rolled for it up until that point. And then you're just kind of practicing the same sort of things on your own in the meantime.
Can I spend the rest of it whittling?
You can do whatever you would like to do. If you want to spend it on whittling instead, you can feel free.
Whittling and... So yeah, how do I do this roll again? I'm sorry, I was actually reading, trying to level up.
So make a dexterity check, which is a flat dexterity check. Nice.
Dexterity, that's 12.
Oh, that wasn't the 18. Oops. It just took a minute to come through.
Yeah. Oh, wait. I'm actually doing this as Raylan, so I have to, like, remember. Okay, so... straight dexterity?
Yep.
So that's a total of 18.
So you want all of it to...
Oh, wait. Is this not leveled up, though? Should I... go back a level?
Either is fine. Don't worry about it.
Okay.
Do you want all of it to coordination? Do you want half of it to whittling? How do you
want
to do it?
I want half of it to whittling, half of it to coordination.
Okay, so 9 to each?
Yeah.
Perfect.
I forget, do I have a new project? Did I start a new project?
You haven't started anything yet, nope.
Okay. Alright.
So not anything official, I should say.
You just have like hunks of wood in like your pack.
I mean, I find them. I pick them up. Yeah.
Oh. Along our journey.
So I imagine.
I want to go check over to Winry.
The rock could only go 3 hours and then had to rest. So I imagine I picked up something while we were on the rock, and that's.
You guys would probably want to rest also, because holding onto a rock for 3 hours straight is probably pretty tiring. Yeah.
So actually, considering that. Yeah, you know what? Yeah, fine. We'll do half and half. All right, thank you.
Mm-hmm. Perfect.
So yeah, everybody... just make it 25, not 24.
Okay. So everybody...
But the boost in everything is too persuasive.
Move towards their feats, but no one has finished anything new yet to this point.
You said I was close, right?
You are close. Jack, you just started yours, so don't be too shocked.
I imagine mine's gonna be really hard too, so
fairly hard. Yep.
Well,
worth it.
May not seem it, but I am glad that the two of you are back with us.
I'm still checking Winry over. Like,
Bryn said she was too.
Yeah, slowly push Jack.
I push back.
I'm fine, but I'm like enjoying like the back massage,
the attention.
After spending days with Rayland alone,
this is true.
Basically, no interaction
with one word answers.
Silently throaty purring going on.
Silently cutting into a piece of wood, just.
What you making?
Well, you guys can start moving, and I think I'm going to ask you guys which way you want to go. Do you want to go through Pitchwood? Do you want to go around it?
I mean,
what's the time difference that Gala would have told us?
I have that. Where was it? You could shave off about a day's travel, 12 hours, by going through the Pitchwood, if you would prefer.
How long would it take to fly 20 miles?
So if you wanted to try to fly over Pitchwood instead, they'd be the same as going through it in terms of time.
That makes sense. Like, I guess, if we flew...
Are you trying to ask how many trips Jack could make back and forth over Pitchwood?
Well, yeah. Would his spell last the entirety over Pitchwood, or would
I'd have to look. How fast...
It's an hour.
So I now have two... I turn into a giant eagle.
And two spell slots.
So I'm looking up what the movement is for giant
feet.
Eagle.
80 feet.
So if we're dashing, then it's 160 feet around. You do the math, Justin.
There's an easy chart for this. I need to remember what it is.
And I can do that for 2 hours. Because I now have two fourth level spell slots. Jack is also hard against going through the woods.
I believe.
So you'd be able to go over and back once with a spell slot, roughly.
Over
and back?
Over the woods and back?
Yep.
Okay.
So we have more
for a spell slot. So if you did two spell slots, you'd be able to take two groups up and over the woods.
Okay.
And then have a little bit of time left over just for funsies.
So then, that's the answer. Most of us ride on Tabaxi. We'll probably maybe take horses to the Pitchwood. And then once we get there, we'll mount up on Tabaxi. I'll turn into a giant eagle and fly across.
Pitchwood. Berg. That's really hard to say.
Pitchwoodburg.
The Pitchwoodburg is right along the river, basically, in kind of the middle edge, southern edge, sort of, of the
Where are we going
forest.
In Dashkabans?
Dashkaban, yep. You're heading over this direction. So the path that you're going to kind of go, you can see this, right?
Yeah.
Yeah.
You're going to kind of go this way, over, if you want. Excuse me, to the castle. Through there, if you want. To the Glassgill Cliffs, up. Timor's castle is right about this general vicinity. The other way of getting there would be to go kind of along this river and up along and around like that. It'd be long, winding, and difficult.
Gotcha.
However you want to get back.
Are there any other, excuse me, towns like along the Pitchwood? Like once we cross over, would we be able to get horses?
If you wanted to try to buy new horses, you certainly could, but you would have to purchase them.
I say we just go around.
Otherwise, the going around path would be like getting to, you'd be kind of going, skirting it around like this, and then back onto the path. If that kind of makes sense. The rest of the trip still being similar.
Because once we do Timor's, we could just ride the horses to Pitchwood, Berg, and then fly.
I mean Dashkabad. What?
Yeah, you mean Dashkabad.
Well, no, because from Dashkabad to Pitchwood, Berg, we could ride the horses and then we can fly to Timor.
Yep.
It just seemed too tricky to kind of like drop horses off and then... So you're saying fly Dashkabad and then go back to Pitchwood Berg and buy horses and then ride those... Wait.
I'm saying ride around because it's around. 20 miles from Pitchwood to Dashkabad.
She's saying if we fly over Pitchwood, then when we land on the other side, we won't have horses.
And all the time we saved won't be...
Yeah. That's why I'm saying we should go around is because it seems like it's too tricky to finagle with the horses and everything.
We fly after Dashkabad.
Yes.
Okay. That sounds great.
Raylan, so Winry, guys... sound okay?
Well, otherwise, if we're flying... How many days travel is it from the Fend to Dashkabad, we said? A couple days?
On horses, it'd be...
Like 3 days?
2.5 days, almost 3 days, yeah.
So, what if we rode to Pitchwood and then just flew as far as we could, the two of us?
Oh, I guess because your spell lasts longer.
We rest, and then we get up the next morning and do it again to get to Dashkabad.
That makes sense, because if you can go over this with your two slots... We can probably make it to Dashkabad.
Or at least close.
You can, because this be about the same distance. Is 20.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, they're the same distance. Yeah, that's great. So we'll ride to Pitchwood and then fly the rest of the way to Dashkabad.
Okay.
Can you see a map again where Pitchwoodburg is?
Pitchwoodburg right is is roughly here.
Okay, that's where I thought. Okay. All right.
So the path that the other ones would have been following, in case you're really curious, while you're flying to Cassie, because you guys would have followed the river, you'd have flown kind of right next to Pitchwood Berg. It just would have been a town on the side of the forest that you guys would have probably seen. And then you'd follow the river up to Gallows Fen from there.
Yeah, I think that's the best way to go, is to ride to Pitchwood, fly over it, and just fly as far as we can to get to Dashkabad, and then if we can't make it, rest, and then finish the rest of the trip. Get horses at Dashkabad, ride to Pitchwood Berg, and then fly to Timor.
Okay. With that plan in place, we will implement it next time, as we'll call this the end for tonight's session.